Chair.
Stuart Nash.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Just talking to part four, I'm going to have a look at clause 72 here, Mr. Chair, and this is talking about resident land withholding tax certificates of exemption. Again, this was an area that we discussed in some detail at the Finance and Expenditure Select Committee. Why people would get certificates, under what reasons, what would the rationale be? And basically, there were three of them. So what I am talking about, of course, is resident land withholding tax. This is by and large covered in part two of the Act, but because this is amendments to the Tax Administration Act, this just falls under this purview of this. So there are three requirements for people who may get an exemption or apply for an exemption of resident withholding tax under this Act. And this is a person who carries on the business of developing land or dividing land into lots or erecting buildings. The reason we did this, Mr. Chair, is because we did not want to... We did not want to dissuade anyone from an overseas investor from coming over here and erecting residential dwellings, especially in a place like Auckland where there's a need for residential dwelling. Perhaps there was we reach a stage where it's hard to get domestic funding, and therefore overseas funding is a requirement to allow any sort of development to occur. And under this sort of circumstance, we thought that the odds of them, well, it would be easy for the IRD to track them down and pay the required amount of tax anyway. And so we thought that the resident withholding tax, which is there, as we talked about in the purpose of this, is there really to stop people from avoiding their tax obligations. So this would make it, we think it would be very hard to avoid your tax obligations if you're undertaking this sort of work. The second area is if they have already had tax obligations under the Inland Revenue Acts before applying for a certificate, i.e. this is an overseas investor of good character, they have a track record with IRD, there is no reason whatsoever for the IRD to suspect that they may skip the country or not honour their tax obligations. So it's a good track record. It's the good character test, in essence, and the good character test is around in a lot of legislation, so we thought that was appropriate. And the third one has applied with all tax obligations for 2 years before they apply for a certificate, and the Commissioner is satisfied that the person will continue to so comply. Again, this goes back to what I was talking about, the good character test. There is no reasonable belief to think that this person or this investor, whether it be a person, a company, a trust, or whatever sort of entity, will welch on their New Zealand tax obligations. So we did think that those three categories were deserving of the ability to apply for an exemption for the residential land withholding tax. Of course, it is not guaranteed. There has to be a process that has to be gone through, but you know, if an investor fits one of those categories, then the odds are pretty good they'll get one. There's section 73 as well, and this is amended officers to maintain secrecy. Actually, secrecy was talked about a lot in the Select Committee in a number of instances, Mr. Chair, and we've alluded to this before in a speech today, and it is my understanding, and it was certainly reinforced by the IRD, that there are a number of checks and balances in place in the contracts of IRD employees to make it very, very clear that they do operate under, a veil of secrecy. What I mean is that the integrity of the tax system and the integrity of the IRD is completely reliant on the fact that that an individual's tax business will be kept absolutely secret. And I have absolutely no reason to suspect that that is ever going to be compromised. In fact, I was talking to a very long-serving, just recently retired IRD senior employee, and I asked him if he thought this was an issue at all in the IRD, or if we need to be a little bit tougher on this, or a bit more transparent, or put better rules in place, and he said no. He said everyone knows that if they break the sort of secrecy clause in their contract, then they're gone before lunchtime. So there is there's a pretty good culture in the IRD for this. The rest of part four, as Mr. Robinson has alluded to, I think every speaker has alluded to, it's administration, it's the nuts and the bolts, it's pretty boring, to be fair. Not that tax is boring. How would I even suggest that? What I mean, it is the sort of Compared to the student loan stuff or the land withholding tax, it is important but not really gripping for the general public.